leadership is both a privilege and a duty. It is best measured in terms of concrete results that citizens can feel in their everyday lives, as well as in the level of trust that they have in public institutions.
Your opening remarks.
Thank you. Brothers and sisters, it is wonderful to have a winner this year. You know, some years we don't have winners. but it's also wonderful that the winner is a she. But it's interesting and also fitting that the she is honored here in Rwanda, because nobody did more for women than Rwanda. Nobody really addressed the gender issue as comprehensively as this country.
To promote reconciliation among the Liberian people. Since becoming president, clearly you have succeeded in restoring confidence and hope to the Liberian people. And under difficult circumstances, you have undertaken courageous institutional and economic reforms. And thanks to you, Liberia is recognized today as throughout Africa and beyond for your strong and credible democratic institutions.
She courageously embraced opponents and fought for generational change and paved the way for her successor. Her achievements have inspired and giving confidence to millions of women in public service. May I just say a slight amendment, not only an inspiration to women, but also to men. In too many cases, leaders have taken over.
As the first woman to receive this award, it is my hope that women and girls across Africa will be inspired to break through barriers, to push back the frontiers of possibilities. Where there's a first, there will be a second, and a third, and a fourth. Liberia's progression toward democratic values, as exemplified by the successful 2018 transition, is reflective of Africa's quest for democracy. It is a continuum of the continent's struggle for liberation and freedom. As Nelson Mandela said in March of 1991, "I belong to the generation of leaders for whom the achievement of democracy was the defining challenge." Trends remain encouraging as young people empowered by education and technology demand their rights to be heard and to be listened to. Africa's evolution illustrates the strong causal effects between democracy and development.
I've been thinking in the rain. So Ibyiza byose nabibone yemo